This episode of How to Spin Yarn has been brought to you by SpinOlution, state-of-the-art spinning wheels proudly made by families in the USA, and by My Local Wool. Find farms, festivals, artisans, and shops near you by visiting mylocalwool.com. Welcome back to Spindling and the tutorial Thickened. This is a how to create a thick and thin yarn as a single. This video is a prerequisite for the shelled plying technique. So if you bought the entire masterclass series, you'll need to spin one of these yarns before you attempt to ply it into shells. So let's get started.
Great.
I'm going to use just a handful of fibers, and I'm going to make thick and thin sections using different types of fibers. And Sarah's going to do just like simple white. So I think maybe I'll start with just top, and then I'll start getting creative. This is a drafting exercise. Decided I like my leader thread in a loop.
Did I have it in a loop?
I don't know, but I've just put it in another loop.
Yeah. Okay, that works. Okay. Oh, this is like a dream to spin.
That is faux cashmere. Okay, faux cashmere is like my favorite fiber. And it shouldn't be because it's not earth friendly, because it's basically plastic, but it's amazing. It's amazing.
It's science.
It's science fiber. Who needs wool when you can spin yarn out of science? Okay.
Okay.
Okay, so the way I do, there's a couple methods, but the way I do thick and thin, you can either, like, if you're a beginner, completely split it off and then reattach it to a glob. And I'm going to talk technical for a second here. When you're creating a thick and thin fiber, the thick globby sections can only be as long as your staple length. So in order to find out how long your staple length is, you want to take your top and start pulling it apart, and you'll see that it pulls apart at approximately the same distance. Like, you can get a stack that goes up to here, and the whole stack is only going to be about 4 inches. So your thick sections should not be longer than this. That way, when you're spinning them, they do not pull apart, because you don't want your thick sections to be weak sections. You just want them to be thick sections. So this is as big as my thick sections can be with this fiber. I'll do the same thing. Well, I guess it wouldn't, it doesn't matter with a bat, because bats are like, all the fibers are all mixed together and all tangled, so you can do any size. But with top or roving, it's all about staple length.
That's cool.
Yeah. So that way, because I used to make thick and thin, and it would like fall apart.
Yeah.
Why is it falling apart in all the thin sections? And I was making way too big of puffs. My yarn is rebelling. I have too many weights on this. I'm changing to a different spindle because I can already tell this spindle is giving me grief. I'm going to draw one size down. Yeah, exactly.
So that type of a thing?
Mm-hmm. I'm going to go to the same size you're on.
Yeah, this one seems to work well. Oh, that's cool.
And you can do these thick and thin sections like equally spaced, or you can kind of have them at random. And the first thing I'm noticing, dropping down one size of a spindle, it goes a lot faster.
Oh! Yeah. I, like, pinched it.
Uh-huh.
I pinched a glob.
Yes.
And then let it go.
Yeah. here's my thick section. So I'm going to draft behind it. And you'll also notice when you're spinning thick and thin, the thin sections in your yarn will gather twist. They will become over twisted. And that's just because twist collects in the thinnest spots in your yarn. That's just how it works. So here's an example of what not to do. I made my poof way too big, and so it fell apart and was weak. So I need to figure out what my staple length is. Yeah, there it is. I shouldn't make any poofs bigger than this. It's really technical. Like, poofs. Poofs.
That's technical.
Poofs are so, so to me it's technical because I can't just do it. Like, I have to measure and evaluate and examine. Okay, so that's not going to come apart. You also may notice when you're spinning this yarn that your thick and thin isn't as pronounced as you've seen in pictures online. You might be thinking, like, my thick and thin, I can barely tell that it's thick and thin. You know, it's just like, that's not very thick and thin. And it's because it's under tension. The spindle is holding it down. And so if you lift the spindle up, you can see it poof. And when you take it off of your spindle, it will, like, fluff up. Okay, so I'm going to pull out another thick section. Spin and then draft thin behind it. Pull out another thick section. It takes a while to get into a groove. What have you found? What is working for you?
I'm finding that one poof per park.
Yes.
Works well. So then I can concentrate on, oh, okay, it's sort of even.
Yes. I think you're right.
If I put it in the same sort of place every time I park it.
I think I'm finding that now too.
Whoa!
I got two poofs.
Two poofs.
I got two poofs. No.
Oh.
Total.
Oh, okay.
Well, I have one poof that I started with, but we're not going to talk about that one. Kind of melted. If you're spinning this yarn, in order to prepare for the shelled plying technique, you can, any poof, no matter how messy, will look beautiful as a shell. So don't worry about making it perfect. It is a different look when you have that perfect look for the shelled plying, but I think both ways look beautiful. Keep on dropping my fiber. I'm also finding that working with a smaller amount of fiber is making this easier.
I'm still trying to find the sweet spot. I had it, and then let's see.
When I'm ready to make a poof, look, watch this. So I'm ready to make a poof here, and I'm actually kind of like pulling my fiber apart and stacking it, and then I'm going to spin all of this. Like it's attaching,
oh, okay.
And then I'm going to move backwards.
Oh, okay.
So that's another
idea.
Okay, so that's like a long poof.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. That's cool too.
So here's a cheater's way to make a poof. So I've done my thin part. I break it off, and then I just kind of stack on roving, kind of pulling it apart, like when we were figuring out the staple length, with all the fluffy ends near the thin part. The thin part attaches to all those fluffy ends, and then I get a big poof of fiber. I think that's my preferred method. I'm doing my spindling face again.
That's cool. So I was doing it before. I was doing like little circles.
Yes.
But this is like a long poof. That's cool.
Yes. So I'll do that again. So we're going to break it off, and then I'm going to pinch it and stack roving on it. And now I'm going to pinch the end of that fluffy roving, spin it into the thin section, and then slide my hands back. And that's my thick and thin. I think that's where I'm getting the most control and the most consistency. Yeah. If you want billowy consistent, I think that's what I just found.
Yeah.
You know what I did when we were doing Rolags? I actually drafted backwards.
Yeah, that might work.
Try that on yours. I'm going to try putting two fibers together now and creating those poofs. So kind of like a combination of the uncarded technique and thickened.
Yeah, that worked. I'm going to try that again.
Yeah. It makes kind of like a sloppier but pretty. Like if you draft it like in the opposite. Here's two fibers together, which I think is really pretty.
I think that's not working on this.
Okay.
I think it's just too slippery.
Yeah, wrong fiber. A Rolag would work with that, though.
Yes.
Because it's already, like, kind of prepared and pre-drafted. Do you want to try a bat?
Yeah, let's do that.
I have a little bit of carded fluff here. You could fluff all this together.
Yeah.
Another one. Little silks. So I think I like to just build my poofs.
Here goes.
That might be easier. I don't know. I'm curious. You could also try poofs of different colors. So if you had like a white fiber, you could take like a rainbow art bat and make just the poofs out of the art bat.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I think that's easier.
Yeah, I think so too.
Since it's all tangled and you don't have to worry about staple length and it falling apart. So if you're a beginner, try an art bat rather than top or roving to start. I just think it's more forgiving.
Yeah.
If you find, I just had a moment where I found that my poof was just not ending, like it was just thick for days. I broke it off and then reattached less fiber and then spun the thin section. So if you find that you're like, oh, I can't get back to thin again, just break it and then reattach.
I'm doing like a leapfrog, so I'll pinch it at the bottom and give it some twist, mm-hmm. and then I'll just skip a bunch.
Yes.
And then
yes.
there's a poof.
Yeah.
And that's cool.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, this is definitely easier.
Is that okay? Yeah. Cool.
Well, because does this have staple length?
I don't know. It's very short.
Okay, maybe that was it.
So I think... you were only supposed to go this big, but it's also very springy and mm-hmm. super slippery. Mm-hmm. I think that was what was hard. So if you're trying to do this with like nylon or silk, like the silk top, that might be too slick. I think you need kind of a fluffy, grabby fiber. I'm gonna make myself another little
so much better.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Very cool.
I'm converting you. You're making yes. such art yarn.
But it's still like smaller and
yes.
There's something about it. It's still a little different. It's not quite.
Not quite so avant-garde.
Maybe that's what it is. I'm not a little as
bright. More controlled. Okay, so I've got like some silk and wool that I just turned into a cloud, and we're going to spin this into poofs, and then I think it'll be a wrap. I just want to make sure that I can repeat this consistently or get into that groove. Because I do think this is more technical than the other stuff we were doing.
Yep, once you find the sweet spot, it's so much easier.
Yes.
Yay.
Once you have the right fiber, too.
Yes.
I think that's one thing that I was learning in my other spinning classes, is I would try to do a technique with the wrong fiber, and I knew it wasn't me. I knew it wasn't the... technique, it was the fiber. And so if you find yourself spindling any of these and really struggling, I recommend switching up your fiber. And if you're a beginner and you don't know what kind of fiber to buy, just a medium wool, just a economical medium wool like Romney is a great beginner fiber. Or art bats. Art bats are great beginner fibers and fun and forgiving. So here's how my kind of blended thick and thins are going.
Oh, that's neat.
Isn't that pretty?
Mm-hmm. That's different.
Yeah, it seems like that art bat is more thick and thin friendly. Mm-hmm.
For sure.
You do want to make sure if you're going to be plying this or any of these yarns in this series to put extra twist in them, because when you ply, you're twisting the yarn in the opposite direction as it was spun, and that untwists the yarn, and you need so much twist that you don't want the yarn to fall apart before it has a chance to be plied. So if you're planning on plying your thickened yarn, add plenty of twist for extra stability.
That's a variety.
Wow,
of
that's perfect. Yeah,
yeah,
that's
like all
really
over the place.
Boom, boom,
yeah.
Boom, boom, boom.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
Well, one per part.
Yeah, one per part.
But they're different sizes, which I like.
Yeah, I like not having like that super consistent, because to me it makes it look hand spun.
Mm-hmm.
And so, if my yarn looks perfect and consistent, it makes it look like it's made on a machine to me. All right. Here's my finished yarn.
And here's mine. Let's
see. Super cute. Yeah, that was fun.
That's pretty cool.
I think what I learned most is it's the fiber. The fiber,
yes,
makes all the difference.
That's the lesson. Moral of this video.
Yeah, the moral of this video, fiber makes all the difference. And mm-hmm. Don't be afraid to stop and start a million times. When in doubt, use an art bat. Cool. Cheers.
Cheers.
Thank you for watching, and happy spindling.